Al-Musaf Sow's Memories of Reflection is one of the few books by a local author accepted for use in the national curriculum of upper basic schools. The book, which was approved by the Ministry of Basic and Secondary Education in 2014, is now being officially launched by the Writers Association of the Gambia. Formally launching the book, Dr. Cherno Omar Barry, the president of the Writers Association of the Gambia, underscored the importance of books in the acquisition of knowledge. For him, the content of books has changed many lives.
Emile Sow has shown much exemplary traits at an early age when he demonstrated his passion to write. But have you ever listened to him speak? He speaks exceptionally well, and his books are proof that he has an excellent mastery of the English language at a very early age. It demonstrates, however, that the writer has style and reads widely. I address this gathering to say that we should read regularly and explore different writing styles on how content and plots are being thrown into the storyline. And perhaps not so often talked about element that all of writers need to uphold is persistence.
Exploring the need for extensive reading, Sheikh Ustaz Abdul Hamid Keski Sedikan highlighted how education, even from the Holy Quran, sets one apart from the unlettered. He believes education comes first in all endeavors.
Education is the best accomplishment in a person's life. And so rewardingly, is the greatest reward someone can acquire. From it is knowledge. And those with that wisdom, that knowledge, Ilma Daraja. The Quran didn't put it Ilma Daraja. If it is Daraja, it would have been single, but rather it is Darajat, meaning the level of you being elevated, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows.
The vulture feeds on the dead, even if it is old.
Gambian writer Modu Lamin Sow, the author of the book, described as crucial writing literature, particularly pieces that celebrate Gambian works. He said local writers will succeed if they are supported to publish more books. The author is fully focused on developing prose for school-going children.
I embody a mind that sees beyond the seven colors of the rainbow. As I understand the language of the dancing sands when they speak snowballs of trees, mixed with wildfire and cold water of silence in a hall such as this. I am yet to see Gambians patronize one another in terms of writing. 2 weeks ago, when Wandifa Samate had his book launch, I doubted if ever Gambians will patronize our books, or perhaps when the Ministry of Basic and Secondary Education should come up with a budget for perhaps book launches, or at least for book publishing, or simply a fund that is meant to support books written by Gambians.
The book launching brought together people from different walks of life. Officials say a moment like this is a bright indication of the country's literary future, with a revitalized writers' club promoting Gambian arts and prose. Here, the CEO of Deco Arts makes a live illustration of his artistic skills as guests walked around the exhibition to buy and grab a copy of Musaf Sow's latest book. Abdulaisi, GRTS.